Good afternoon. My name is Lisa Balsera with USF Health. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're delighted to be here with our new medical director for the Tampa General and USF Bariatric Center, Dr. Christopher DuCoin.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Thanks so much for giving us this time. So, Dr. DuCoin, we're here at the Bariatric Center. It offers comprehensive care involving weight management and then potentially bariatric surgery. What can a patient expect when they first come here?
Yeah, it's a great question. So it's a very inclusive and multidisciplinary clinic. And what I mean by that is we've got multiple providers here. So we've got surgeons, we've got medical doctors who are dedicated just towards weight loss management. They're called bariatricians. We've got nurse practitioners, dietitians, and then we've got even other specialists such as cardiologists, pulmonologists. So when people are obese, they usually have other comorbid conditions, hypertension, diabetes, heart problems. So when they come to this clinic, all of that can kind of get treated and optimized for either medical management or surgery. So there's a litany of things they can expect. One they can expect is to be comfortable. The clinic is really set up for them, from the entryway to the chairs to kind of the entire facility is built around that specific patient population. But first and foremost when they come is what we do is we provide baseline information, and we have a free information session that we provide daily here.
That's excellent. And what would the factors be that you go into in evaluating whether a patient is a candidate for surgery?
Yeah, so there's some guidelines. The NIH, or the National Institute of Health, in 1991 set up specific guidelines for surgery, and kind of insurance companies have followed that. So we use something called BMI, or Body Mass Index. It's a measurement based on your height and your weight. And if it's greater than 30, you're considered obese. If it's greater than 35, it's actual morbid obesity. And with that, you qualify for surgery if you have a comorbid condition, such as hypertension, diabetes, sleep apnea. If it's over 40, then you automatically qualify for surgery. So that's one of the things we have to use, whether or not you're a surgical candidate or not. And then there's a whole other group of things we look at. You know, everything from what the dietitian's input is, while you work with the dietitian, everyone meets with a psychologist, so we make sure you're mentally prepared for the operation. I tell people, it's not like going to the surgeon saying you got like a skin lesion or bump, you sign a consent form and it gets removed. It's a real training process. So it takes about 6 months from the day you come to the information session to the day you go to the operating room. And you're training for that procedure. So we really work with you, losing some weight, getting your heart and your lungs ready. But it's also made it one of the safest procedures we do. They say it's safer now than having your gallbladder removed. It's safer than elective knee surgery, elective hip surgery. It's one of the safest elective procedures we offer.
Okay, it sounds truly multidisciplinary.
It really is.
So how does the surgery affect or help diabetes and sleep apnea and so on?
Yeah, so it's amazing. And it's one of the reasons I really love this job. It resolves, which means completely eliminates or reduces almost everything, right? So obesity is kind of a disease that touches every organ system in your body. And when we're reducing obesity, or that extra weight the body's got to carry, the lungs, the heart, the kidneys, everything starts working better. There's a funny story I like to tell. There was an endocrinologist or a doctor whose life was dedicated to taking care of diabetes, and he walked up to me one day and he punched me in the shoulder. I said, "Why'd you do that?" And he goes, "Do you even care about diabetes?" I said, "Of course I care about diabetes." He goes, "You don't understand. I've spent my whole career treating." And what he meant by that, just medically treating diabetes. He goes, "You do this procedure and you cure diabetes." And it's a pretty amazing process to go through with the patients. You, from a medical perspective, you've seen them get so much healthier. But then from that personal perspective with the patients, you know, 6 months to a year after surgery, it's one of the most beautiful things to see. Their self-esteem goes up, their confidence soars, they like looking at themselves in the mirror. It's a privilege to give them their life back.
I can tell you're very passionate mm-hmm. about it. You also do a lot of work in esophageal cancer. So tell us about how you worked in that area, and what's the connection with the bariatric?
Yeah, so they're both what you call foregut or stomach or esophageal pathology. I did training after my basic training in surgery, both in California. I went as far as Germany to learn some of the novel or new procedures. And esophageal pathology is a little bit different. Usually it limits what you can eat, kind of blocks that tube from your mouth to your stomach. So it's the other end of the spectrum. Patients are usually malnourished and you're trying to help them. Now, cancer is a little bit different. Esophageal cancer is a very, very intense disease. And again, it's kind of multidisciplinary, but it's tough. So there's options with that, too, that we help the patients with.
And at Tampa General and USF, there is a program, a care team that takes care of that?
Definitely. So here, when a patient comes, they can expect to meet both the surgeon who would help take care of them, kind of walk them through the process. And they'd meet with the medical oncologist and the radiation oncologist. A lot of these patients, even before they go for surgery, need chemotherapy and radiation to really shrink that tumor to make the surgery more practical.
And other kinds of surgeries that you do, what other treatment options are there?
Yeah, so it's a great question. This is where I went to Germany to a certain extent, where I still do the I wouldn't say old-fashioned, but the open or large incision procedures. It is cancer. We got to make sure we get it all out. But I've been versed or trained in both robotic and laparoscopic. Both of those are the small incision mm-hmm. procedures, which reduce pain, length of stay in the hospital, blood loss afterwards. And for some really early stage tumors, we can even take them out now. No incisions, just a scope down the mouth, which is pretty cutting edge considering that same tumor about 10 years ago required major open abdominal and thoracic surgery.
Wow. Well, we're certainly very happy to have you here in Tampa Bay.
Thanks, Lisa. It's great to be here.
Thank you.